There is so much more to Spain than the museums of Madrid, the architecture of Barcelona, and the endless parties of Ibiza. Along the Atlantic coastline of Spain lies a treasure trove of the country's best-kept secrets. We begin our journey in Galicia and span our way towards the Basque Country in search of good food, places, and in one way or another, heritage.
We will be exploring the most luxurious sides of northern Spain and dive into the local lifestyle to show what makes this country a global favorite and undisputed leader in culture, tourism, trade, and heritage. Join us for our best season yet.
This year, our lives have drastically changed, but the quest to bring you the stories on people, places, and meaningful experiences continues.
This is Raul Manzano, EIC on the move.
The old saying, feel at home, can be taken quite literally at this hotel, because this was actually a traditional Galician home. Set by the River Umia and surrounded by pretty gardens, this hotel is the perfect way to imbibe traditional, rustic Galician charm. Thank you so much, Rodrigo, for having us in your beautiful hotel. Yes. Can you tell me more about the hotel?
Sí, buenos días. Buenos efectivamente. Días. Esta edificación data de primeros del siglo XIX y inicialmente fue una fábrica de papel continuo.
¿A papel?
Papel continuo, sí, sí, la primera de Galicia. Luego cesó en esta actividad y se transformó en una fábrica de hilados de algodón. Suministraban, hacían los hilados de algodón y los suministraban a la empresa textil. También cerró, que tuvieron corta vida los dos sí. proyectos empresariales, y luego se transformó en un aserradero de madera. También cerró, y estuvo mucho tiempo abandonado. Se arruinó todo, y nosotros en el 2007 lo recuperamos para la actividad de hostelería, de alojamiento de turismo rural, ¿verdad?
How many rooms do you have in the hotel?
Tenemos ahora mismo contamos con 13 habitaciones y próximamente vamos a incorporar dos habitaciones más.
Dos
a mayores.
So 15.
15, 15, okay. Sí.
Who helped you decorate the interiors of the house?
El interiorismo lo hizo mi mujer, Begoña Quiven. Sí. Que es el alma de la casa y la que diseñó y decoró toda la casa.
Very beautiful house. Muchas gracias for having us here in your house.
Gracias a vosotros, y es un honor teneros aquí, de verdad que sí.
Do you see the excitement in my face? 3 years ago, we passed by this place, Torre de Rio, to check it out. And we instantly fell in love with this place. Unfortunately, there were no rooms available. It was fully booked. But today, I'm back and I've got the whole hotel to myself.
Wow. What an incredible room. High ceilings, the beds very positioned well, looking out into the forest. Incredible. The motif of the room, I think, is shabby chic, because old furniture has been made to look very chic by hammering and by staining. And of course, the bed sheets, very shabby chic also, because it has lace and printed pillows. The best part of the room is the view. So look at the view. This is the garden view, the date palms up there in the highest point of the garden. This is the million-dollar view. I can't wait to spend the night here.
The world's most famous pilgrimage is El Camino de Santiago de Compostela. I've walked it twice, and I'll never get tired of that first sight of Santiago.
Any pilgrim will tell you that once the magnificent cathedral comes into view,
all the fatigue and aching feet and calluses will be forgotten. I am back in Santiago de Compostela. You can see the cathedral behind me. I was here in 2019 and I promised myself that I would be back in the Jubilee year in 2021. Unfortunately, the pandemic struck and I couldn't make it. But Pope Francis has extended the Jubilee year to 2022. And I'm back here at the cathedral to do my penance and my indulgences and to have my sins erased. Hey Ruben.
Hey Raul.
Good to see you.
How are you?
Good, good. It's been 3 years, huh?
Just 3 years.
Yeah. And church has been renovated now.
Yes.
Yeah.
Took over 10 years to renovate and restore the church, and now it's ready to...
Yeah, it's like brand new in church.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah. So let's go to the church.
Let's go to the church and make a walk.
Just entered through
the holy gate or the holy door.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Okay. So, what's the significance of the doors?
So, this door is the door that only opens in the holy year when the 25th July falls on Sunday, which is every 6, 5, 6, and 11 years.
Okay.
And what we see in this relief is the full life or chapters of of Saint James.
Okay. From.
From the beginning.
From the beginning.
The beginning of,
his life.
This history, when Jesus approached to Peter, John, and James, telling them to join him.
Yes.
Then the duty of St. James was to spread Jesus' words as far as possible to the west end of the earth.
Okay.
Then his pilgrimage to Hispania, to Spain, and his way back to Jerusalem, his beheading.
Mm-hmm.
And then the traslatio, when the two disciples of James took his corpse, put it on a small dinghy, and moved from Jerusalem to Galicia to bury him in Santiago.
Okay.
That's what we see in this sixth relief, six panels.
Okay, perfect.
We can go now visit the relics of St. James, which are underneath the main altar.
Okay.
And then see the main altar of the church.
Okay, go.
Let's go.
Galicia is on the Atlantic coast, and with a history that dates all the way back to the Romans, there's a deep love for all that comes from the ocean. Carril, like Manila, is famous for its clams, and today we will try this famous seafood here. Los Peperetes is one of the last few businesses left in Spain that practice the old method of canning top quality sea urchins and anchovies all by hand. It is all manually intensive, but the quality of the seafood speaks for itself.
Vale, pues ahora vamos a probar el producto que habéis visto cómo se trabajaba. El caviar de
Sea
porridge.
Oh, wow.
Wow, do you like this?
Mm-hmm.
Es uno de nuestros mejores productos.
Sí.
Para mí es de mis favoritos, la verdad.
Incredible.
Increíble. Sabe a mar, ese toque salino. Sí. Es una muy buena descripción de Galicia en un sabor. Para mí sería el caviar de Erizo.
So these are sea urchins, which are taken from the sea, and they're here. They're cleaned.
and they're taken out from the shell and then put into a can.
Take out the orange part of it, which is like this caviar, which is just a flesh you eat.
Yeah.
And everything is doing manually here.
Everything's done manually.
Ladies that are very
delicate. Yeah.
Entonces esto lo que vamos a conseguir después es esto, que es la hueva. Hueva. Esto está sin limpiar aún.
This is not already clean.
Not yet clean. Mm-hmm. This is like liquid gold.
Yes, exactly. Yeah. Like caviar.
Like caviar.
Liquid gold.
Yeah.
Very appreciated in restaurants.
Yeah.
Because this is like a bite of sea. This is a flavor.
Yeah. Because you can taste the sea and the salt and everything, right? This is the last stage, the canning. After cleaning, it's put here. And how much is each can? 105.
105.
105 grams.
Everything must be manually. It's impossible to do it in a different way.
Because if it's machine, it will all get crushed.
Yes.
Right. It's very delicate. Perfect, perfecto.
Thank you.
So it's a bite of Galicia, and you can taste the Atlantic Ocean here, and this, you can see how intricate this is. The women take it out by hand and put it in the can by hand. Everything is done by hand by women. So we're trying the sardines that David Beckham orders. Okay. I'm going to try it now. You have to be very delicate and not break the fish, okay? So this is brined in olive oil. And you can taste the olive oil is the best in the world. Again, the saltiness of the Atlantic Ocean. You can taste it here. Now you know why David Beckham comes here to buy this can of sardines.
Galician gastronomy revolves around the bountiful sea life of the Atlantic Ocean. In the case of this quaint restaurant on a hill, Chef Pepe Vieira offers more than just a different take on Spanish cuisine. It becomes a one-of-a-kind experience.
Tell me about this restaurant.
Okay, this is the house of Pepe Vieira, one of the most famous cooks in Galicia. Mm-hmm. And this is like his little house in O Camino da Serpe.
Okay.
And this is a nouvelle cuisine restaurant that gets all the platters straight from the sea and from the farms around.
Oh, yeah, okay. So she said this is mackerel, right?
Smoked mackerel. With wasabina.
With wasabina, not wasabi.
Not wasabi. It's actually this kind of little leaf, which is over.
This one.
Yes.
I have tweezers exactly like this because I cook. Mmm. Again, the sea, the salt, everything very Galician.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Galicia is always Atlantic gastronomy, coming from the sea, saltiness, and fresh.
Yes, excellent. This is what chulas.
This is chulas in Spanish.
Yeah, and chulas are like little bread.
Like little bread with some egg.
Yeah.
And fried.
Okay.
Traditionally with sugar, but in this case it's salty.
Okay.
With some mushrooms inside, stuffed with mushrooms, truffle.
Truffle, yeah.
And a pinch of boletus, which is a different variety of truffles.
Okay.
And so eat with the hands.
Yeah.
Maybe.
Cheers.
One bite.
Wow. There's like an explosion in your mouth.
Like mushrooms?
Yeah, you can taste the truffle, mushrooms.
Everything
and the truffle,
comes from the earth.
From the earth, yeah. A very earthy dish. Yeah.
Exactly.
Okay, let's dig in. Oh my God. Wow. Very creamy.
That's a bit sweet.
Yes, sweet.
Sour.
You can leave me here now. I'm not going to move. Again, you can taste the sea and the salt. And you all can, you can also taste the corn.
It's a bit sweet.
Yeah.
It's very good.
Excellent. Wow. From the appetizers, we now move to the mains. It's like a trip down Galicia, right? From that side, now we're in this side.
Like to be at home of Pepe Vieira, yeah, in his living room, mm-hmm, have an appetizer, now move into the table to eat the main.
Good, yeah. Very good.
And the first main is lobster. Mm.
Okay, so remember we won't eat the lemon slice.
We just take it like
and then let's
and
try
the fish.
Yeah. Salt, brown sugar, the seaweed, yeah, with finch.
And smoke.
Yeah, and coriander. Mm.
You can taste sweetness from the honey, sourness from the goat's milk, and the texture from the meringue. Excellent. Thank you so much for arranging this and for the Galician Tourism Board for bringing us to this wonderful restaurant. This is one of the best meals I've had in Spain. Truly, truly amazing. Many gardeners and a generation of plantitos and titas are well aware of the famous events like the Chelsea Garden Show or the equally famous gardens at Versailles. But here in Galicia, the Pazo de Rubianes Botanical Garden boasts of the largest collection of camellias in the world. The garden has a history of 600 years, which also includes a vineyard and an award-winning winery. Hi, Miguel.
Hello, Raul.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
So, this is such a beautiful setting. It's a beautiful place.
Yeah.
Can you tell me a little more about it?
Yeah. Okay. So, first of all, happy welcome to Pazo de Rubianes.
Thank you.
So, Pazo de Rubianes, it's a Pazo, as we can see.
Yes.
With more than 600...
years old.
Yeah. 600 years old of history. Okay, the first Pazo was built in the 1411, mm-hmm, in the 15th century. The Pazo that we saw right now here,
yeah,
it's a rebuild of the 18th century.
Okay.
Right now we are in the French garden.
Yes.
Okay, it's the first garden that we saw in our visits.
Yes.
Okay, it's a welcome garden.
Yes.
I remember us like, of course, it's a little bit smaller.
Yes.
Like the Versailles.
Like the Versailles, yeah, gardens.
It's, yeah. Yeah, it's the same. Yeah. The philosophy, yeah, of that period. If
so, what else do you have here in the Pazo?
So now here we have the first, the main goals, yeah, here. Of course, is just to visit the different gardens,
yes,
the botanical park.
Yes.
We have a very, very old trees.
Yes.
And then we have the vineyards.
Okay.
We have 25 hectares of vineyards.
Yeah. That's, and you make your own wine.
Yeah, that's
wow.
Wine. Yeah, yeah. We elaborate around 100,000 bottles per year.
That's a lot.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, it's 100% Albarino. Mm-hmm. Is the wine of this area.
Yeah.
Right now, as you say, is the first, is the best moment to see this Camellias because it's the blowing season.
Yes. Okay. Let's go.
Okay, let's go. Over here.
So now we're in the vineyard.
Okay. Yes.
All Albarino,
yes. Yeah, yeah, yeah. So here in Paso de Rubianes we have 25 hectares of vineyard.
Yes.
It's 100% Albarino.
Yes.
We have 80% of the vineyard planned as the French way.
The French way.
And 20% of the vineyard is planned, as we can see here, is the typical way to plant here the Albarino in Galicia.
And then you have a winery here to produce the wine.
Yeah, yeah, we have the winery. And we produce ourselves our wine. Yeah, yeah. We don't buy any kind of.
So all the grapes are your grapes.
Yeah, yeah.
Could we see the winery?
Yeah, yes, sure.
Okay,
let's go over there.
Let's go. Let's take a look.
Okay. And now we are inside of the original cellar.
The cellar.
Yeah.
This was the original one.
Yeah, this is one of the oldest buildings here in the land. So it's from the 15th century.
Wow, 15th century.
Yeah. We have here our collection of the wines.
Yeah.
That's the wine that we produce here, 100% Albarino.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. We have Paso de Rubianes.
Yeah.
Okay. This wine, last year, we won the trophy as the best white wine in Galicia.
Yes.
Okay. Then we have the Albarino of García de Camaño.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, this wine is with 2 years old.
2 years old, yeah.
And then we have the most exclusive wine, it's the 1411.
This wine.
Okay. Yeah, this wine. We elaborate only 1,411.
That's why it's called 1411.
Yeah, yes. 1411 was the date that Mr. García Camaño founded the first path of here.
Okay.
Coruña, the capital of Galicia, has long been under the shadow of Santiago. It is often overlooked by travelers who are under the spell of its more famous neighbors. But with its long beach and culinary attractions, it is well worth the visit.
So where are we now?
Now we are in Plaza María Pita. It's like the main square of A Coruña. It's a typical Spanish Plaza Mayor, closed in its four sides.
Yes.
What we have behind is the City Hall.
This is the City Hall.
That is from the beginning of the 20th century because we had a former one in the old town.
Yes.
And the name María Pita comes from the local female heroine, María Pita, which defended in A Coruña at the end of the 16th century. Her husband died, attacked by the English army with the captain Francis Drake, and she said, whoever has honor, please follow me, encouraging this local army to defend and defeat the British invaders. And then we see also the coat of arms of A Coruña, which is the Tower of Hercules, the lighthouse.
Silent witness to the long, long history of the North Atlantic, Torre de Hercules is an architectural integrity that truly defines time. It is the only fully preserved Roman lighthouse that is still used today.
Hi, Anna.
Hi, Raul.
How are you?
Fine.
Can you tell me about the legend of the Tower of Hercules?
Yes, of course, of course. The Tower of Hercules has a very important legend, and Hercules came here and fighted with a giant called Geryon during 3 days.
3 days?
Yes, yeah. 3 days. And he won his fight and cut his head.
Cut the head of the monster?
Yes, okay. Yes. And he built, Hercules built a tower above his head.
Above the head of the monster.
Yes, so it is said that the head of the giant is under the tower. Yes,
okay.
Maybe you will find it.
Thank you, Anna.
You're welcome.
Hi, Vanessa, nice to meet
you.
Thank you. Can you tell me about the tower?
Yeah, of course. The tower was made in the first century after Christ by the Romans.
Okay.
But what you can see outside is from the 18th century.
Okay.
It was restored,
So what does the tower do?
This is a lighthouse.
Okay.
This works as a lighthouse. This is the oldest lighthouse in the world.
In the world, huh?
In the world, yeah.
Okay.
It's in UNESCO. It's a World Heritage Site since 2009.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So it guides the ships.
Exactly, yeah. Even today, it guides all the ships over here.
Okay. So, thank you very much again.
You're welcome, Raul.
Thank you, Vanessa. Across the peninsula sits another gastronomic gem, Aborda de Veira. It's a one-star Michelin restaurant that encapsulates the phrase dining experience. A spectacular view of the ocean while partaking the best of the sea is undoubtedly Galician. I'm with Chef Luis. Of the restaurant, so I'm just going to ask a few questions. What inspires you, your menu for the restaurant?
Bueno, nuestra inspiración nace en lo que veis aquí,
sí.
en la mar que tiene nuestra Galicia tan personal, tan. Estáis en el sitio más mágico del mundo, que es Galicia, que la gente, que la cultura que tenemos aquí. Eso es lo que hace que todos los días soñemos con productos del mar, mezclados con las carnes tan maravillosas y con la huerta que tenemos. Entonces, la inspiración nace de salir de la puerta, abrir la puerta de casa, salir a la calle y encontrar a esa persona que cultiva al lado de tu casa, ese pescador que sale todos los días a pescar con esa lanchita. Es el día a día de Galicia.
So, what is the importance of local ingredients in your restaurant?
Bueno, yo creo que este restaurante, si no se hiciera en, si no estuviera aquí, no sería como mágico. No tendría esta visión tan personal como la que tengo yo bajo pues nuestra cocina de mezclar la carne con el pescado, porque esta es una ciudad muy tranquila, Galicia es un sitio muy tranquilo donde y que cada vez que abres una puerta aparece algo, ¿no? Entonces esto es Galicia.
Thank you very much for a wonderful meal.
Esperemos que lo hayáis pasado muy bien,
sí.
Que lo hayáis disfrutado y que salgáis satisfechos.
Sí.
Nada, muchas gracias.
Muchas gracias.
Gracias.
Non-Spanish speakers know that cerveza means beer. Estrella Galicia has been brewing beer since 1906, and it's a big, big part of Spanish cerveza culture. I am sure that most Filipino beer goers have tried Estrella one time or another at their local Spanish resto.
So to those who know their beer, this place is a must-see. To get deeper into this, look no further than the Museo Estrella Galicia, a museum built within the factory. It's a Willy Wonka paradise for beer lovers. Oscar, thank you very much for having us
here. You're welcome, Raul. You're welcome. Yeah.
So you're going to take me on a tour of the museum.
Yes,
right?
Yes. Okay. Well, the Beer Museum is inaugurated almost 3 years ago, mm-hmm. in 2019. Mm-hmm. And well, we'll be able to visit the first beer museum in Spain.
Yeah.
And we are inside an active brewery. Okay. So that means we have to use those fingers to pass all the trucks, right? So Mega is the museum's name, which is Mundo Estrella Galicia, mm-hmm. like Estrella Galicia World.
Yes, yes.
And well, it's 3,000 square meters of interaction.
Okay. Perfect. Let's go.
Okay, let's go then.
Yeah.
You first, Raul.
What a beautiful place. This is part. Yeah.
This is the first idea of this beer museum. Is this this original, because this is the 1972 brew house.
Okay.
This brewery was built in 1972, okay. And this room was in use until 2013.
Okay.
The original tanks are in copper.
Yes.
Right? And the boiling was happening here.
Okay. It's not beer yet.
It's beer, but it's not finished. It's okay. Not ready yet.
Okay.
But you will feel, smells beer already.
Yeah, it smells like beer and it tastes like beer.
Tastes like beer. Mm-hmm. And do you feel it's cold enough?
Yeah, it's cold.
But it's cold enough?
Not enough.
Because you are drinking that at the temperature of fermentation.
Okay.
Which is about 10 degrees.
Yeah, okay.
It's not like bottle, which is cold.
Cold, yeah.
Right?
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
For taking me on such a wonderful tour of the brewery. I had so much
fun.
Thank
you very much.
This is one of the most amazing experiences I've had in here in Galicia.
I mean, we really
everything is so experiential. Yeah.
Yeah, it's all about touching, feeling. And enjoying.
Yeah.
And this is one example. Yeah. Five of our beers with five Galician cheeses.
Wow.
But we are very pleased that you come here and we love that
you... Thank you so much for taking me around the plant.
You're welcome.
Yeah.
You're welcome, Raul.
Okay.
And
thank you.
Like we say here, salud.
Salud, yeah.
Our cheers.
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 The Hotel Boutique Noah is simply a diamond in the rough. As soon as you step into any room, it immediately invites quiet contemplation and at the same time, total relaxation. It is the place I need for a little me time. Nearing the end of our Galician trip, sleeping in this hotel is going to be the cherry on top of a full day. Hi, Vanessa.
Hello.
Thank you so much for having us at Hotel Noah.
Nice to meet you.
Nice
Thank
to
you.
Meet you. So what's the concept behind the hotel?
Open spaces,
yes.
That everyone can see also the views, the wonderful views that we have.
Okay.
Everything is facing to this area, and also to have this Nordic style in all the spaces that we have. Very natural colors, very comfortable and to feel cozy.
Yeah.
Here, no?
Each of the room faces the sea.
Yeah.
Yes. So is there a difference in different rooms or all the rooms are basically the same?
There are different type of rooms.
Yes.
The most difference is the appearance of the rooms and also the distribution.
Yes.
But all of them have different experiences for the guests. Yeah.
So can you show me to some of the rooms?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah. Okay.
Come on.
Yeah. So Vanessa, we're in my room.
Yes, this is your room now.
A lovely room. Okay. And the view again, as you said.
Yes.
It's the sea.
This is the view. Yeah. This is, as you see, a very different room of the regular ones that we can find in a hotel.
Yeah. The bathtub is open. I mean, the bathroom, right?
Exactly, yes. Here, the concept, as is the name also of the room, is cube. That's because we have three different cubes, no?
Okay.
The bed, the bath area, and then the bathroom and the sanitary as well.
It's called the cube, the TV. I mean,
TV is here, no.
So it becomes a wall here.
Exactly, it's a part of the furniture.
So, yes.
Yes. Okay. We also have another room if you want to have a look.
I want, because I'm dying to see that other room.
Yes,
stay. Okay, let's go.
First, follow me.
So we're here now in another room.
This is the Noah bath, yes, a different type of room. Yes. You see also the distribution of the bed.
Yeah.
Again, we have the glass, with the shower.
Yes. So yeah. This is more of a couple's room.
It's more for a couple, yes. Yes. Yes.
So again, the design is all very sleek, very Nordic, right?
Exactly, and very functional.
Very
so everything
functional.
Has its place.
And everything again here is sustainable wood, sustainable shampoo and everything.
Exactly, everything. Our cosmetic is sustainable. We have also, as you see, we don't have any picture here, but we have also green plants. It's everything is natural as well.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
And then here now, the bathtub is by the terrace.
Exactly.
Yes.
Yes.
As you're taking a bath, you have the view of the castle.
Yes. Yeah. And it's also one of the desires from many people. Yeah. No, it's one
so
of
it's
the demands.
My room there, the cube. And this
and
one.
The bathroom.
These are the favorite rooms.
Exactly, one of the most favorite ones, yes.
I want to see you have a bigger room, right? The suite.
Yes,
because
you want of the suite one.
Yeah,
it will be a little different.
Yes.
But of course, we keep also the view.
Yeah, the view as usual, yeah. So we're now in one of the bigger rooms.
Exactly, this is the sweet one.
The sweet, yes.
This is our baby, no? The biggest one and the most special.
The special.
The special
I get a lot of guests request for this room.
Yes, yes.
So we're now in the living room.
This is the living room. Exactly.
Yes.
As you see, we have a big space to be here. We can use the sofa also as a bed.
As a bed.
The tall table is like a bar, and also to be used as an office.
And
then
in the room, the view.
Exactly. Again. Yeah. This is consistent.
Yeah,
no?
Consistent with all the rooms.
Exactly.
Here.
In all the rooms, we have the nice view. Exactly.
And where is the bedroom?
The bedroom is on the other side. Yes, here.
Oh, nice. Also,
Here you will see also. A difference on the bed.
Yes.
This is bigger.
Bigger bed.
2 meters per 2 meters.
Yes. And again, everything is sustainable here.
Everything is sustainable. We have also the same type of colors.
Yes.
Calm colors as well, in order to invite you to rest, no, and to like to be here.
And then this is where the TV comes up, right?
Exactly.
Yeah.
We do the TV.
Yes.
As you see, we didn't want to have the TV in front of you because the main view would be this. But here you have the surprise in case you said, okay, now I don't need to be outside and I can see the...
Especially maybe at night when you can't see the view.
Exactly.
Oh, perfect.
That's one of the purpose, not to have it hidden and then you can use it whenever you want. No?
Okay, so thank you so much, Vanessa, for showing me all the rooms.
Thank you.
Yes,
and
I'm going to enjoy my room.
Yes, sure.
Okay. I'd like to thank you, Pilar, and the Galician Tourism Board for taking care of us, as always.
Thank you. Gracias.
Yes, and muchas gracias.
It's a pleasure. You're always welcome in Galicia.
Yeah.
Gracias. Esperamos de vuelta.
Sí. Being back in Galicia brought a lot of memories and new discoveries of luxurious hotels and Michelin-starred restaurants shared with great company. And those are the reasons why I'll keep coming back to this beautiful place. This is Raul Manzano, EIC on the move.